Hello everybody, this is Gustavo Galas from copahost.com web hosting. This video is about Google Fonts, how to use custom Google Fonts on your website using HTML5. First of all, you can browse for Google Fonts at fonts.google.com. There are many options here. You can just browse their website. Now I'm going to show you how to use any of these fonts on your website. So this is my website, a standard website with no custom font set. The first step is choosing a font, and then you have to link to this font in your header. So we're going to use the link tag. Remember, it must be placed in the header of your HTML file. We are choosing the Pacifico font. Let's just write down the font name, Pacifico. So we have to use this link from Google Fonts. Right after family equal, you have to write the font name. I'm going to place the copy of this tag on the description to make things easier for you. So now we have just linked to the font. Now we have to make a small CSS style sheet to tell the browser that we want to use this font on our web page. For that, we're going to use the style tag. We have another video where we describe in details how to work with CSS style sheets. I'm going to place the link here for you to check this. So in this small style sheet, I'm going to place body. Body means the body of the HTML file. Now, font family. Pacifico, which is the font we have just linked from Google. Now let's save the page and reload to see how it looks like. So that's it. All the website is just with the new font we have linked from Google. In this web page, we have a simple structure. We have only a header tag, an H1 tag, and a paragraph tag. Let's say you only want to apply this font to the heading tag, not to the paragraph. So you must go here on the style and place H1, which is the equivalent of the heading tag used here. This way, placing H1 instead of body, we are telling the browser only to apply this font to the H1 tag. Now, this is how it looks like. We have the paragraph with the standard font and the heading tag, the H1, with the new font. For instance, if you want the opposite, to apply only the font to the paragraph, not to the heading, you would place P here, the paragraph. As we have the text with the P tag, it will apply only to this paragraph. So, that's it. So, if you want to use a different font from Google, you should only change here the font name. To explain it better, let's link a second font from Google. I will copy this tag, this link tag. I'll come back to Google here. And now I'm choosing this Emetic SC font. Then I have just placed Emetic SC, which is the font name. Now we have configured for the P, for the paragraph, the font Pacifico, which is linked here. Now I'm going to place for the H1 the other font called Amatic SC. We're going to place font family, then we're going to reference this way the font. Remember that the font name must always be equal to the font linked here. If you place a different name, of course, it won't work. And also, these link tags and also the style tag must be inside the head. So, we have now, for the P, for the paragraph, the font Pacifico from Google. And for the H1, the heading tag, we have the font Amatic, also from Google. Let's save. We have here the H1 tag, and we have here the P. Let's see how it looks like. Now we have the different font here, and a different font in the paragraph. You can also change the font size here, for instance. You can simply add the font size attribute to the style sheet. Now let's reload to see how it looks like. So we have a very small font. For this, let's make a bigger size. 50 pixels. So it's way bigger here. For detailed instructions about CSS, in this other video, we'll talk more about CSS. So this is how to use Google Fonts on your website. It's very easy. If you have any questions, you can just comment this video.